Hello, good morning students. Today we will study about the calibration of thermometer. In the previous class we have studied about the transmission of heat, what is the thermometer, concept of heat. Today we will discuss about the calibration of thermometer. This calibration means what? What is the calibration? Calibration means it is the process of what? Formation of scaling of thermometer. It is the process of scaling of thermometer. As you know, there are the different scales in the thermometer: Celsius, Fahrenheit, and the Kelvin. Yes, in these three, Celsius, Fahrenheit, Kelvin, there is scalings. Yes, that the scaling of that thermometer in its equal parts. They are what? That is the process, that is the what? Calibration of thermometer. It means the process of determining the scale in the thermometer. You have seen in the thermometer, there are the scaling. In the thermometer, you have seen. You have seen in the thermometer scaling like this. 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 40. In this we have seen the scaling. So no, that is the what? This is done by the calibration of thermometer. So this calibration of thermometer means what? The process of determining the scales in the thermometer, that is called what? Calibration of thermometer. So in this process, there are the two points are taken in the while you are calibrating the thermometers. The two points are taken. First one is lower point and another is upper point. Now I will show you about what is the way of calibration, how the calibration takes place. Yes? Suppose here is a thermometer. Okay, I will draw you here one thermometer. Here is the thermometer. In this thermometer, you have seen the scalings are there. 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 243. There is a calibration in thermometer. Means how this thermometer calibration takes place? Yes. So there is a first of all, these two points are taken. One is the lower point, fixed point, and another is upper fixed point. The two points first of all determined. Suppose this is a thermometer and this thermometer by the calibration the thermometer, the two points are taken. One is the lower point and another is upper fixed point. Lower fixed point and upper fixed point. When this lower and the upper fixed point are divided into its parts. Now I will show you. So the lower, how the lower fixed point is determined? Yes, these are the main questions. How the lower fixed point is determined in the thermometer? So the lower fixed point is determined by the help of the simple experiment they are doing. As you know, by the pure melting ice at the external temperature and the pressures, due to the taking one ice of the thermometer, keeping it into the pure melting ice. Suppose here is one stand. Stand, one thermometer is fixed. Okay, this is the thermometer. This is the fuel and ice. What is pure ice? It means when this, the level of this mercury in the thermometer, when it comes to the point at the time, this point is determined at the lower point. Lower point. How it is determined? We said, means lower fixed point is determined by keeping it into the pure melting ice at the standard temperature and the pressure, that is a what standard pressure at the lower point is what 0 degree Celsius, and Fahrenheit it is 273 Kelvin, that is the at the pressure of 760 mm of Hg, that is the what pressure of the what mercury, the atmospheric pressure of the sea level, that is the 760 mm of Hg, at that pressure, yes, the ice, the thermometer is kept in the ice, and what will happen, that lower point are determined in this way, what happened, lower point are determined. So another is upper fixed point, how the upper fixed point is determined. Now another question is, how the upper fixed point is determined? The upper fixed point is determined by the pure water, boiling water, and we know that pure boiling water is 100 degree Celsius. Now take another example, take one beaker, round bottle glass, then I guess, and keep this your thermometer and keep it into the stand, okay, and started to keep it in the water, pure water. At that time, what will happen? This, when the level of this becomes 100, at the boiling point of water is 100, at that time we determine the what? Upper point. Upper what? Upper point of thermometer. So in this way, that is the what upper thermometer is what? 100 degrees Celsius, or in Kelvin, we will say about the 357 degree Kelvin. So in this process, in this way, the calibration of the thermometer is determined. Okay, in this process, what will happen? The calibration of thermometer is determined. In this means how many parts it has been divided. Its equal parts they are divided. In the lower fixed point, we have seen in the Celsius, 100 equal parts are divided. 100 equal parts are divided in 100 parts. That is the 0 degree to 100 degree. Means its equal parts is divided one point in 100 parts. In each parts, all these are divided into its single parts. That is the word 100 in 100 parts. So look, so another boiling is also determined at the same as in the 100 parts, it is determined how many it rises to 100 degrees Celsius, at that time the upper fixed point is determined. In this way, what will happen? The calibration of the thermometer is done. Okay, you can also, by the help of this experiment, you can also calibrate the different thermometers if there is a noise scaling of thermometer in that thermometers. So how the calibration of thermometer is done? Calibration of the thermometer is done by taking the what? Lower fixed point and upper fixed point, and each part is divided into each equal parts. Okay, in this way we can determine what calibrate, we can calibrate the thermometer. Okay, now temperature scales. In the previous day I told you, yes, about the scaling of the thermometer by the calibration of thermometer. So now what the Celsius, the temperature scales are mainly the three types. One is the Celsius, Fahrenheit, and the Kelvin. What is the unit of temperature? That is the Kelvin. But generally, we are using what? Mainly the Celsius and the Fahrenheit. So now the temperature in scaling, the in the Celsius scale, the lower point is 0 degree and higher point is 180 degree. The lower point of Celsius is what is 0 degree and higher is 100 degree. And each is divided into 100 parts. Each is divided into 100 equal parts, and one part is called 1 degree Celsius. Yes, one part is called what? 1 degree Celsius. As the same as in Fahrenheit scalings, yes, the each there is the lower point is what? Lower fixed point is 32 degree Fahrenheit, and upper is 202. In this scaling, there are 180 equal parts. 180 equal parts are divided. It's the same as in the Kelvin, lower point is 273 degree, whereas upper is 373 Kelvin. So in this 100 equal parts is divided, 100 equal parts, and each equal parts is said to be the work 1 Kelvin. That is the work temperature in scales. So what is the lower? This is the lower and this is the upper. And this is the lower scaling of Celsius, Fahrenheit and the Kelvin. And another is what? Upper Celsius current. So there is the relations. Relation between C, F and K. What is that? The relating each others. So here is our formula, two way of the converting the different scales into the Fahrenheit and into the Kelvin, and Kelvin into the Celsius and Celsius into the Kelvin. So what is that formula? It's C minus 0 means Celsius minus 0. What is the lower point? 0 degree. And each is divided into how many? 100 equal parts. We have seen lower is 0 degree. So no, and each is divided into how much? 100 equal parts. Another is equal to F minus 32 by 180. Each is divided into 180 each parts, and the lower is 32. And it's equal to K minus 273 by 100. So this is the word relation. Upper point fixed point to the lower fixed point, upper fixed point to the lower fixed point, upper fixed point to lower fixed point. This is the relation of between the Celsius, Fahrenheit and the Kelvin. So in this process also we can solve the different types of what questions related to the home, to the Celsius scaling, and you will see how it is converted. I will do one questions for you, how to convert it in the Celsius, Fahrenheit and the Kelvin. Just one, take one example, 50 degree C into F and K. At that time, how we will do convert? What is our relations? What is our relation we have seen? C minus 0, that is the lower fixed point, by the it's equal to divided into 100. So here is the Celsius is given. First of all, we have to take the relation of the Celsius and the Fahrenheit. This we have to take the first of all. Celsius and the Fahrenheit. The C minus 0 by 100 is equal to F minus 32. F minus 32 by 180. Now we have to solve, instead of the C, we have to use what? 50 by 100 is equal to F minus 32 by 180. Or we can say this 0, this will be cancelled. This 0, this will be cancelled. 5 into 18 is equal to F minus 32. So now we have to multiply this 18 into 5. 5 is the 40, carry 4, 90. 85 the 90. Now 90 is equal to F minus 32. Now this minus will be changed. When it will come this side, it will be, sign will be changed. So 90 plus 32 is equal to F. Of F is equal to what? 90 plus 32. How much? 20. 122 degree F. It means in this way we have to convert the different questions from the Celsius to the Fahrenheit and Fahrenheit to Kelvin. Now Kelvin, what is the relation? Now I have to take C and K relation. I have to take the relation of C and K. C and K. So C is 0 minus 100 is equal to K minus 273 by 100. Now we have to take the relations. And C is what? 50 by 100 is equal to K minus 273 by 100. This 100 will be cancelled. Or K minus 273 is equal to what? 50. Or K is equal to 50 plus 273. Or K is equal to how much? Now 375, 12. Now 323 will be cancelled. In this way, we can convert the different types of the questions related to the work, converting to the Celsius into the Fahrenheit and the Kelvin. So I will give you some works to have to convert yourself in your home. So you can write, you know, note, you started to note in your copy. you have to convert in this way, you have to convert in your home Celsius into Fahrenheit into Kelvin into the Celsius, okay, and you have to practice more and more in your home. Just for your HW, you have to do now convert, okay, now 37 degree C into F, DF and degree K. Another is 320 degree K into F and C. Another is 32 degree F into C and K. Another is minus 40 degree F into K and C, Kelvin and Celsius. Another is 30 degree C into F and K. In this way, you have to solve your work. These are your questions from your home, and you have to practice and practice. If you have any problem related to this chapter or any problem, you can consult me, and otherwise you have to give the work in the websites. Yes, you have to give your problems. Okay, thank you, class.